Hello colleagues, so today we will be discussing an important case. This case is very important, especially for those doctors who are working in the emergency departments. So this case needs a bit of attention. So I'll give you a brief history. This is a 45 years old gentleman who presented with apprehension for a few days. Now this ECG was done in emergency. At that time he was not having any kind of chest pain or apprehension at all. So what do you think is happening on this ECG? So let me walk you through it. First of all, we always need to identify whether it is a sinus rhythm or not. So this is a sinus rhythm. And is there any issue with the conduction problem or not? So for that, we need to look at the PR intervals, the QRS intervals, and the ST segments. Well, PR interval appears normal, QRS is again normal. We can see some changes, especially in the T waves. So look at lead AVL. So there is T wave inversions. And there is T wave flattening in lead 1. So when these changes are seen, we always have to see the chest leads as well. So now look at the chest leads. So first of all, let us see, are there any clear cut abnormal findings which can lead you to the diagnosis? So we have to rule out a myocardial infarction definitely in those patients who present with apprehension in the ER. So there is no clear cut ST elevation at the moment. So what will you do? Will you clear this patient or do you need to do the further investigations? Now, if you know that what's the T wave morphology is like, then you can be a bit suspicious of these changes which are seen on this ECG. So now let us zoom in the T waves. I have zoomed in the T waves for you. These are the leads V2 and V3. Now what do you think is happening? So I have marked the findings with the arrow. So do you think this is a normal looking healthy T waves? No, that's not right. Look at the T waves. So there is a positive terminal and followed by a negative terminal and then coming back to baselines. So it's a positive and negative biphasic kind of T waves. And similar T waves are found in the lead V3 as well. And now look at lead V4 and lead V5 and lead V6. So these T waves are called biphasic T waves. In the lead V6 and lead V5, they have extended. So this means that whole of the chest leads are showing some findings. So what does this suggest? This condition is called Wellen'S syndrome. So what is Wellen'S syndrome? So for that, I'll show you some more slides. So basically, Wellen'S syndrome is a kind of a syndrome in which, although it is not an MI, but it is that stage which can lead to an MI. So this is a very tricky situation, especially for those doctors who work in the emergency departments. So if they are always looking for these ST changes, ST elevation, or T wave inversions, metrical especially, that suggests that ischemia or infarction is going on. But if they do not have in their mind the biphasic T waves pattern, then they can miss a very important diagnosis. And unfortunately, this can even lead to death. So it's very important to understand the findings and what is this Wellen's syndrome. So our case was this one. But sometimes, more commonly, deep T vein versions can also be a spectrum of Wellen's syndrome. So be cautious, although in our ECG this was a pattern, but this is more common in the literature. So ...75% of the individuals who have Wellen, they present with deep inverted T waves in especially lead V2 and V3, but they can extend to other chest leads as well, as we have seen it before. So this is the most common type of Wellen's, but this is also again seen sometimes. So 1/4 of the patients will present with a biphasic, just as in our case. But most importantly, look at the leads V2 and V3, because the anterior chest leads are most commonly involved leads in cases of Wellen's syndrome. However, in rare cases, the inferior leads or the lateral leads can also show Wellen's, but that's not common. So always remember these two patterns. What else can we see in these types of patients? So on the ECG, you have to see three more things apart from the T wave changes. One is there should be no Q waves, because if Q waves develop, then this suggests that the patient is having an MI, especially anterior wall MI. There should be no significant ST segment elevation. Only a minimal ST segment can be occasionally raised. So up to 1 millimeter can be raised. And normal precordial R wave progression as well. Now let's apply this to our ECG. So this was our ECG, and now, so there are no Q waves. So now in lead 1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, there are no Q waves appreciated. The next point is there is no ST elevation to suggest anterior wall MI. So you can see there is very minimal ST elevations. Okay, very minimal ST elevation. They do not meet the criteria for anterior wall MI. This is more of a J point uptake. And the R wave progression is pretty good. So there is a good R wave healthy progression. So our ECG also meets all these three criteria as well. So this is a classical Wellen's syndrome with biphasic T waves. Now let's discuss some clinical pearls as well. So Wellen's syndrome most commonly involves the left anterior descending coronary artery, which supplies the anterior chest wall, and definitely it can lead to anterior wall myocardial infarction if not catered earlier. These patients typically presents with inguinal symptoms, okay, but usually at the time of presentation and ECG changes, the patient might be totally asymptomatic. So don't be fooled that the patient is not having or not a risk factor for myocardial infarction. So always suspect even the patient is not having any kind of chest pain or inguinal pain. Very important. The cardiac enzymes can be perfectly normal or they might be minimally elevated, which can often be disregarded, especially in emergency settings. And it's a pre-infection stage. So this means that if you do not manage these patients timely, then This can lead to a life-threatening anterior wall MI. Okay, so as the point has been discussed, that these patients typically only present when the patient is free of chest pain. So always look for the ECG changes, especially when the patient is free from chest pain and the patient is having a lot of risk factors and you are suspicious of some ischemia or any chance of having infarction. So always be vigilant to identify this pattern. And these patterns should always be managed by giving medical treatment, by antiplatelets, by statins, and all those tests which you take for a patient who is suspected to have a myocardial infarction, because in the majority of patients, they will ultimately have anterior wall MI if they are not managed timely. And these patients then should also always undergo a coroangiogram to delineate the lesions. Thank you very much.